present than usual. So that means that tomorrow we play an important game, and we know that. That it's an important game because it can be a key game. If you win tomorrow and we are a little bit lucky that there's something happening in the other game, we can have more points in front of our opponent. And then maybe a victory against Zimbabwe here can give us the first place. So we know that, but at the other side, we don't have to be nervous about that. We have everything to win. Our opponents have everything to lose. And this is a big difference on mentality. If you have to win something, this is positive. If you can lose something, this is negative. So you are a little bit on that level, a little bit advantaged when we compare that we are with our opponents. At the other side, we know from the game of Saturday that we play against an opponent, a very strong opponent, a good playing team. But Saturday, as I said to the guys during the halftime, we don't need a trophy of beauty. We just need to win that game. And we did it with the right mentality, with character. And that's something that makes me very happy. Because in the future, they told every time, yes, Bafana, Bafana, when they have an important game, when it's they can't succeed. I think we prove the other side of Bafana Bafana. And it's not only with good football like against Ghana. If we have to fight, we fight for it. And I'm very happy about that. Tomorrow it will be a different game. We play there on a very, very, very bad pitch. And I don't understand if you have a team like Ethiopia, who is a team who play combination football, that you let them play on such a bad field. So, but okay, that's their problem. Tomorrow we will play on a good pitch, so we will be aware of that they will be maybe better than even there. But we are ready for it. And we had a bad trip behind us. 6-7 hours in plane, 3 landings during the night. But what I saw on training yesterday was something very good. I know that the guys were tired, but what I saw, the mentality they made the training of yesterday, has given me, how can I say it, it made me happy and give me confidence that they will be ready tomorrow to play that important game. Thank you.
Thank you. Taking questions for Coach Broos before we move over to Rushine.
Thanks. Coach Tsepo from ENCA. Coach, are you after a short space of time, you've transformed the national team. Unbelievable. Are you surprised with where the team is now after 3 games? Is it surprising or you expected for the team to be where you are?
Yeah, we are first, eh? Okay, but I know what you mean. We started here 1 month ago with the first camp. And when you see the steps we made, it's very good work from the players. I can only ask some things. I can only give them some things and give solutions. But at the end, it's the players who have to do that. And when you see a little bit of our games, game against Zimbabwe was hesitating. You saw a team was not confident, didn't believe in the qualities. Then you saw 3 days later a team who was confident, who played good football. And now, 2 days ago, you see a team that fights for them. So we make big steps, but we are not there where we wanted to be. And it can't. It's impossible on 1 month that you are already achieved what you like to achieve. So, but we are in the good way, and I'm very happy with what the players give me. So ask things, they try to do it. Sometimes They can do it better than other times, but they will do it. And that's the most important thing in their team. And you see that it's growing. When I compare with the first days 1 month ago, when I see this team now, the behavior of this team, the behavior of the players in the team, yeah, that gives me confidence for the future.
And then John T.
Good afternoon, Coach. I'm sure you're aware now that there will be 2,000 fans here tomorrow.
Yeah.
How significant is that going to be? I know you've not been playing, but you know, the coach, how significant is it going to be for the players to finally play at home in front of fans who will be supporting them?
It will be a little bit strange, I think. Eh? It's a money. 18 months or something like that, that they played for a public, for supporters. But at the other side, and that's the most important thing, it will be a support for us. You have always a bad moment in the game, and then you need your supporters. So in the previous months, you have to do it yourself. Now you will have that support, and I hope. Yeah, there will be not so much, but I hope we will hear them very loudly, because it will give us motivation to go on and motivation to win the team, to win the game. And certainly in the moments that the play is not so good, the game is not so good, then you need those guys. And let's hope tomorrow that they are with 2,000 all behind us, and it will be a great support.
John T.
John T from the Citizen Coach, just to ask you, obviously in the first half in Bahia Gale created a couple of good opportunities, Ethiopia, and Roman made some good saves. Defensively, you can't have been 100% happy with what happened there, especially in the first half. And also, in terms of winning away and then coming and playing at home, sometimes you might get it into your head, oh, we've won the away game. Now we're going to win the home game easily. How do you guard against the kind of complacency,
no,
just in general?
Yeah. I'm sure that mentality will not be in that team. That I'm sure of. Because I see how their guys behave themselves. How their guys are treating them, their teammates. How they are training. Again, if you see what a trip we made to Ethiopia. And then on Sunday evening you have a training. And you see the guys happy, you see, they're making a training like they have to do, then I'm sure that they will not be tomorrow on the pitch with the mentality, ah, we won in Ethiopia, this will be an easy game. Not at all. Not at all. I'm very confident about that.
And then, sorry, just the first question, which was about the defence. They had two one-on-ones with Ronald Williams where they cut through your defence perhaps a bit too easily.
Yeah, okay, but you can't play a perfect game. It's impossible. Some moments in the game, you make not a mistake, but you're not good positioned or whatever. And in those two cases, we were not in a good position. But that can happen. 90 minutes. Yeah, okay, against Ghana, we did it. Ronan could read the paper, the newspaper, during 90 minutes. There was no... But you can't do every time a game like that. And again, it was not easy, the game, with the bad pitch, good opponent, whatever. And then, yeah, there are moments you give chances to the opponent. And therefore, it's very important that you have a good goalkeeper. So the spine of your team has to be very strong with the goalkeeper, central defenders, central midfield, and the guy in front who scores. If you have that, you have a good team. So Roman showed us that we can count on him. So very good for us, but I'm not angry or I'm not nervous, because we give two chances to them. Then we have to count on Roman, and thank God they did it.
Yeah, I know it wasn't easy, traveling. You know, we had to fly from Joburg to Tanzania, from Tanzania to Addis Ababa, and then another flight, a domestic flight to Bahir, something, Bahir da. So the traveling was quite difficult, the guys were tired getting there. So it wasn't easy, you can imagine. You know, we had to adapt to new climate as well. But, you know, having said that, you know, we knew that we're not there on holiday, so it's not going to be perfect. Conditions is not going to be perfect. What was most important for us is just to, you know, stick together in the difficult times and know why we're there, and that is to win the match. And that's what we did. It wasn't easy. You know, like the coach said, the playing field, we couldn't play our normal game the way we wanted to, but we managed to win, and that's the most important, you know, to win football matches, especially, you know, playing an important game like we did.
The coach has also spoken about team spirit, Rushin. Perhaps talk about the mood in the camp and just how it is, you know. I know the coach keeps a close eye, but he speaks about a team that delivers against the odds, regardless of what he asks.
Yeah, I know, you know, team spirit is very high in the team. You know, we all want to achieve the same thing, you know, and that is to qualify. But we need to take it one game at a time, and that's what we're doing. You know, we're all working hard for each other, you know, collectively, and we know that if we do that, you know, it's very possible to qualify. But yeah, having said that as well, you know, we just need to continue going. We're halfway there, we can't rest on our laurels now. You know, so hopefully tomorrow, you know, having the fans back, we can get a positive result and make them proud.
Questions for Rushine?
Thanks. Rushine, Sapo from ENC. I remember before the people were playing, I spoke to you, you were happy that here comes a coach that believes in youngsters, and then now you are playing. I mean, what is special about the coach? You guys, it's a new look, Bafana Bafana. It's a positive, it looks like the road is good, but what is special about him?
Yeah, he gives us the freedom to play. You know, everybody's happy with him, you know. He's like the way he puts out the team, you know, everybody understands what they need to do on the field. And I feel like, you know, if you have that and you have a coach who believes in you, and then you'll fight on the field for him. You know, we all want him to succeed and he wants us to succeed as well. So it's easy to play for a coach like this, you know. We want to do well for him. Like I said, so yeah, the mood in the camp, everybody's happy to just play for him. So hopefully we can continue to do well. You know, obviously having youngsters in the team makes it extra special. You know, so it's a new generation. We want to create our own legacy, and that is what we're trying to do now.
Any more questions?
Rushine, this person coming from the CBC News. The coach did explain that we played the game that we played away, the pitch wasn't the best, despite the fact that Ethiopia had a ball-playing team. Now you guys should be playing at home, and having played Ethiopia, now you would know what to expect. You are the danger man. So do you think you guys should be better prepared for tomorrow's game?
Yeah, definitely. You know, we're not used to playing on fields like that in the PSL. You know, so they obviously have more experience. That's why they were better on the ball than us. So now we're playing on FNB, you know, we play week in, week out at FNB, so we will be well prepared, you know. Like I said, we've played on FNB quite a lot, so tomorrow's game will be different, you know, we will be better on the ball, we'll be more confident, and I'm sure it'll be a good game, because both teams like playing.
Yes?
Rushine, I know there's still a way to go, but the progress you guys have made as a group, as a squad, is there a part of you that's dreaming about the World Cup, but, you know, because it is a huge incentive. I know motivation is certainly not lacking, but are you dreaming a little bit about it somewhere in the back of your head?
Definitely, you know, for me, for not only for me, for everyone, you know, it can only be a dream to play in the World Cup. And, you know, like I said, we're halfway there. We need to continue working together as a team like we have, you know, approach every game with good mindset, you know, good mentality. And I feel like if we do that, you know, it's very, very possible that we can get a good result tomorrow, you know, because we're playing home and we need to win home and then make sure we don't lose away. So, yeah, no, it will be very, very special. You know, we haven't been in the World Cup for quite a long time. So for us to be able to achieve that will be very, very special. You know, it'll put the country on the map as well. And also it will give us exposure, you know, to hopefully have more places overseas. Because that's what we want, you know, we have so many good players in the country, but we don't have enough playing overseas. And yeah, hopefully we can do that and achieve it.
Kaniso
here from School 24. Fans are coming back for tomorrow's game. What does that mean for you as a player?
Yeah, we haven't played in front of fans for 18 months now, you know, and it was very difficult, you know, to find motivation to play. Sometimes it even felt like you're playing friendly matches. Now to have the fans back will be a big motivation for us, you know, and especially also playing for your national team in front of fans. It's quite special. I don't know if there's any better feeling. So having them there, you know, it's going to give us a lot of motivation to obviously try our best to win the match tomorrow. So, yeah, very, very excited. And, yeah, hopefully we can do well.
Any more questions? Sure, go ahead.
I don't know whether the question was asked. Tell me something about Joseph on sports.
Sorry, Tammy, would you mind just to remove your mask?
Okay.
We can't hear you.
Sorry, I'm not sure whether the question was asked about the fans attending tomorrow. Safa Communications just informed us that at least 2,000 fans will be allowed to enter the stadium. How much of a boost is it that you'll finally have some voices behind you tomorrow?
A big boost because they're supporting us, you know. We haven't felt it in a long time, like I said. You know, most games feels like friendly matches most of the time. Now having them back will be a big boost for us, you know, and it's also a big motivation. You know, I know there's a lot of people supporting us, but having them there will be a big motivation for us to just, you know, do our best and try and win the match.
Thank you.